I'm about to get you open. That's what's up. What's good, Power Director peeps? It's Saturday, and today I'm gonna show you how to make opening credits using Power Director 18. Here we are in Power Director. If you're new to my channel and you wanna learn how to use Power Director, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. If you've seen a movie in the past 80 years, then you've probably seen opening credits. Opening credits usually consist of a visual sequence and titles that provide the names of the actors and the title of the movie. So, let's go ahead and open up a can of credits. First, I want to go ahead and create my opening sequence. Now, I want my opening sequence to start off with dead space, and then I want a planet to come up into the frame and then stop. So to start off with that dead space, we're going to need to bring a color board into our timeline. So I'm going to go up here to the media room, and then I'm going to go here to color boards. I'm going to go ahead and select a black color board. I'm going to hold down my left mouse and I'm going to drag this down to track one. Then I'm going to go ahead and click on duration because I want it to be 10 seconds. And I'll go ahead and type in 10 and hit enter. And now I've got a 10 second color board. Next, I want to go ahead and add the animation that I got from digitaljuice.com of a planet spinning and the sun rising over the horizon. So we can see that animation here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to left click, hold this down, drag it down into the timeline. Now, I want a copy of this right behind it. So I'm gonna do Control C. I'm gonna hit the end key on my keyboard to move my playhead to the end of that clip. Then I'm gonna do Control V to go ahead and paste it. And I want one more copy of it. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the end key on my keyboard. And I'll hit Control V again. Now this one, I only wanna be 5 seconds. So I'm gonna place my cursor at the end until I see two arrows pointed in opposite directions. Hold down my left mouse. I'm gonna drag this to the duration, says it's 5 seconds. Now I want one more color board here at the end, another black color board because I want it to fade to black at the end. So I'm gonna go back to color boards. Drag one down here to the end and leave it right there. Now I need to go ahead and make some adjustments to this first clip of the animation so that it rises up into position. So I'm gonna double left click on this. I'm gonna make sure that my playhead is at the beginning, and I'm gonna go ahead and place a position keyframe here. And now I'm gonna go to object settings. And you can go ahead and drag this down until it's off the screen. But what I'm gonna do is just type in the parameter here. I'm gonna type in 1.5 and hit enter. And now it's off the screen. It's actually down here at the bottom. If I scroll down, you'll see it's down at the bottom of the screen. So that's the first position where I have this first keyframe. If I move my playhead to the end, I want it to now be on the screen fully. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in 0.5 for the Y position and hit enter. And now it's full screen. So if you play this back, it'll go ahead and rise up on the screen. So now I'm gonna go ahead and click on OK. So on this last clip, we want the planet to fade to black. So we already got the black color board behind it, but we need to make a fade here. So I'm gonna double click on this clip. I'm gonna click on fade. And then I'm gonna click on enable fade out. And I'll go ahead and click on okay. So now if we play this here, we'll see that it's gonna fade out. Now what we need to do is add our titles. So the first title I want is to be at about 5 seconds in. So I'll just go ahead and type 0500 and hit enter, and my playhead will go to 5 seconds. Now I want to go ahead and go to the title room. And I'm going to go to all content. And I'm going to go ahead and drag down the default title to track two at the 5 second mark.
And now you want to double click on the title. And the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and change the text here. So I'll double click on that. And what we want to do is go ahead and change the text to a font that we got from defont.com. And the font is called Alien Robot. So we'll go ahead and click on the font paragraph here. And here we see Alien Robot. So we'll select that. Then we'll go ahead and double click here and we'll type in. You can size it up and drag it into position here. We want it centered and near the top. And now that we got that set up, we're going to go to animation. And then we'll go to in animation. And for the in animation, we're going to choose wipe right. Then we'll go to out animation. And for the out animation, we're going to choose fade. And then we'll go ahead and click on OK. So we got our first text there. And now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and copy this title. So we'll left click on it and we'll do Control C, which will copy it. And the next clip we want to put about a second after this one. So since this is 5 seconds, it starts at 5, it ends at 10. So I'm going to type in 11 here. And hit enter, and it'll go to the 11 second mark. Then I'll go ahead and do Control V, and it'll go ahead and paste that same title right at the 11 second mark. So now we'll double click on it to open it up. And we're going to change this text. So I'll double click in here, put the name of the next actor. And you can go ahead and click on it and use your arrow keys to move it over to make sure that it stays right on the same line, or if your hands are really steady, you can go ahead and use the arrow. It's up to you. Now, for this one, we want to make sure that the color is coming onto the letters because we want to make it look realistic. So if it's casting light, we want to make that light show on the letters. So what we'll do here is we're going to go down to the fill type under the font face section, and we're going to change this to a two-color gradient. And then for the end width, we're going to click on the color picker. And we're going to move the playhead to a position where we can see the color. And then we'll go ahead and pick a color on here. That looks pretty good there. And we'll click on OK. And we want to make sure that it's coming from the bottom because that's where the color is coming from. So now the top is white and the bottom has the kind of like the color is being cast onto it from the bottom. Now we can go ahead and click on OK. And remember, it has the same animations, the in animation and the out animation that the last one had because we copied it. So now we want to go ahead and copy this title. So we'll left click on it. We'll do Control C. We want it to be a second after this one. So this one ends at 16 seconds. So we'll go ahead and click on the track, we'll type 17 and hit enter. Our playhead goes to 17 seconds and then we'll do Control V and it'll go ahead and paste this title on here. So now for this one, because we already got the color we want, we got all the animations, all we need to do is change the words. So we'll go ahead and click in here. And we'll go ahead and click on it and use our arrow keys to move it over. And then we'll click on OK. And so now we want to go ahead and add the title of the movie. So we want to move that to the end here. We want it to be about 9 seconds long. We want it to be longer so it stays on the screen a little bit longer. So we want to go ahead and have it, since this is about Let's see, how long is this bad boy? 40 seconds. So let's say we'll go to 25 seconds here. So I'm gonna type 25 and hit enter. And then I'll left click here and I'll do control V and it'll paste the title here. And then I'm gonna drag this out till about 9 seconds. Matter of fact, let's move this over here. I wanted to start at 26 seconds. So now we're going to go ahead and double click on this clip. And we'll go ahead and change the name to the title of the movie. And this time we want to go ahead and drag this down to the bottom. We want to go ahead and change the gradient color. So we'll go ahead and tap on the eyedropper and we'll select that color there. Go ahead and hit okay. And now also we're going to need to change the direction because now it's coming from the top. So we'll change the gradient direction to show it coming from the top of the letters. And our in animation, we want to change that to a fade. So we're going to go to animation. Then we'll go to in animation and we'll change it from wipe to fade by selecting fade and we'll click on OK. And now we can go ahead and play this back and see what it looks like. Now that opened things up. If you like what you see, I'll leave some links to buy Power Director in the video description. I know you want more Power Director love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.